British and Irish Lions rugby fans have started claiming Melbourne pubs as their own ahead of tomorrow night's clash with the Wallabies. And as Henry Peters discovered, many are in fine voice hoping for a victory from the visitors.
One day out and Melbourne's pubs have been taken over. The Lions faithful have their vocal cords warmed up and ready to roar. Hardly a Wallabies fan in sight as a sea of red lions mark their territory.
What would a lion do?
Former Wallabies captain Stirling Mortlock will be front and centre in the commentary box for the match, asking the nation to rival the Lions' support.
We don't necessarily sing the whole entire game, but I'm sure we can match their volume. I'm sure we can match their spirit and their passion.
Merchandise shops have also been cashing in on the Lions tour. This store here is hoping for a Lions victory tomorrow night and the spending frenzy that would follow.
They're on holiday, they're here to spend some money.
1-0 down in the best of three series, the Wallabies know they face an uphill battle.
Across any sporting code, some of the best performances are when the chips are down and people, you know, stand up.
For the Lions, a win would mean series victory and a hero's homecoming.
We spoke about it being a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, you know, in Australia to try and win a test series. We've got the chance to do it on Saturday.
This Lions tour is the biggest rugby event in this country since the World Cup back in 2003.
The match will be broadcast live on Network 10. Henry Peters, 10 News.
And we're joined now by Roger Aldridge, who's at Etihad Stadium, where tomorrow night's clash will take place. Roger, it's a very different-looking stadium to what we're used to at this time of year.
Yeah, it certainly is, Stephen. The goalposts are up. They're a little bit different, of course. Just two instead of four. The new lines have been marked. Even the sponsors' products are a little bit different here. Of course, this really is the calm before the storm. Tomorrow night, this place will be absolutely packed to capacity. It is a sellout. And as we saw in that last story, that it's been an invasion of the British and Irish Lions fans. Red shirts and white skin has just been invading Melbourne all week, and there's been plenty of controversy for the Wallabies too. Of course, they've had plenty of injuries. Curtly Beale and James O'Connor have been controversially snapped with a couple of fans, and then the news that their skipper's acquittal at the hearing the other night could be overturned ahead of the third test. So plenty of drama is exactly what we expect when the British and Irish Lions take on the Wallabies. We'll have plenty more later on in sport.
Roger Aldridge reporting from Etihad Stadium.